Hey, CoinTubers, welcome back to the channel. I'm making this quick video because the release date for the Star Wars The Clone Wars series, which is going season 7, has dropped and will be airing on Monday, the 17th of February. So, when that episode drops, 3 days after it drops, I will do a breakdown video of the whole episode in itself. What I think is pretty cool is that Ahsoka is coming back, which is going to be really, really interesting, considering how she left the Order. And here is a video as to how she left the Order.
Ahsoka, I am so sorry about everything.
You have our most humble apologies, little Soka. The Council was wrong to accuse you.
You have shown such great strength and resilience in your struggle to prove your innocence.
This is the true sign of a Jedi Knight.
This was actually your great trial. Now we see that. We understand that the Force works in mysterious ways. And because of this trial, you have become a greater Jedi than you would have otherwise.
Back into the Order, you may come.
They're asking you back, Ahsoka. I'm asking you back.
I'm sorry, Master, but I'm not coming back.
I need to talk to you.
Why are you doing this?
The Council didn't trust me. So how can I trust myself?
What about me? I believed in you. I stood by you.
I know you believe in me, Anakin. And I'm grateful for that. But this isn't about you. I can't stay here any longer. Not now.
The Jedi Order is your life. You can't just throw it away like this. Ahsoka, you are making a mistake.
Maybe. But I have to sort this out on my own. Without the Council. And without you.
I understand. More than you realize, I understand wanting to walk away from the Order.
I know.
So, So the way she was feeling was pretty devastating to me personally, because I quite like Ahsoka, and actually pained me to see how the fact that, you know, one of her own Jedi Knight, fellow Jedi, could set her up. And the fact that she, that the council didn't trust her enough to stand up to the Senate and essentially stand up to Tarkin and the Chancellor. And I particularly like Tarkin is a bit of a, he's a bit of himself, a bit of a lap dog to Palpatine, essentially. But what's interesting is that Ahsoka is going to be going involved in the Mandalore campaign, and we can see here is a picture of her on a talking to Vex and standing beside her is the Duchess Satine's sister, which was previous second in command before he was beaten by Darth Maul. And what I think is going to be really cool is also the fight between Ahsoka and Maul on Mandalore. And the fact that Maul, as we can see here, is wielding a double-bladed lightsaber. Which, if you remember, in season 6, was it? He was actually wielding the Darksaber and his own lightsaber, which was cut in half from Obi-Wan in the Phantom Menace, and is just using that single saber. So that's going to be interesting, is actually using Savage's saber style, or if he's actually built a new one. What I'm actually hoping for this season is that we actually get to see the Battle of Coruscant, and we see how General Grievous kidnaps the Chancellor, and just to see how he manipulates the Jedi further in seeing if the clones have any more evade behavior or any more bad blood towards the Jedi during the Clone Wars. I do hope that we do see via Order 66 and see how Ahsoka and Rex do escape. Or if they do escape, because of course Ahsoka showed up in Rebels wielding two lightsabers, but she's got, but her blades are white. And let me just see if Yoda communicates with Qui-Gon any further, if he communicates further with Master Qui-Gon, and like what happened in the last two play season six. So that's gonna be interesting as well. So that's pretty much it for this quick video, what I hope to see in the new season of the Clone Wars. And we get introduced to a new clone trooper squad, which is not the 99 squad, so they're like a special forces. And from the look of the tower, the clone in charge looks a bit crazy, so I think he's a bit of a happy trigger for the clones. Like, just, going for its blows and don't worry about playing, just shoot our way to it. And we also see that Vex is starting to also question the war a little bit too, because he said, I've lost so many brothers, 3, 4, Hev, and he named them Fives, Echo, Heavy, and he starts to think, is this war worth all three of their deaths, right? Is this going to end the way we hope it's going to end, or has it just been a waste of time, all for nothing? So, yeah. So guys, I'll be covering all of the new season of the Clone Wars here on the channel, episode by episode. I'll probably get uploaded 3 days after each episode airs, which means I could be doing uploads twice a week, so normal time on Wednesday, and I'll probably do the Clone Wars on a Thursday, or I've got no content other than the Clone Wars, I'll just stick to the Clone Wars being uploaded on a Thursday, just so I can give you a 3-day window to watch the channel itself, so you can follow what I'm saying and I'm not spoiling the episode for you guys. That's pretty much it. So, do the usual, like, subscribe, share the video, that helps me out, that helps to grow the channel a bit. I'm up to 7 subscribers so far, so I hope that hopefully I can get a few more during the year, which will be nice. But that's it for this video, guys. So yeah, this Star Wars, the Clone Wars Season 7, what do you guys think of the new season coming out? What do you guys think? Drop a comment down below and we'll talk about what you guys think of the new Clone Wars season, what you guys want to get out of it. So thanks guys, and that's it for today's video, and I am out.